going out, launch morning, after breakfast, everybody anxious to get strapped into the vehicle. Roughly 7 million pounds of thrust. It was an exciting ride for us. There was a lot of racket, shake, rattle, and roll here. Very rapid turn, or roll maneuver, that is, to head downrange.
Things ticked along quite well throughout as we watch Vance, Bruce, the mid-deck.
To start on our respective tasks, my first task was getting the port side MMU ready to fly and checking it out and starting into a check flight, followed by some translations up and down the payload bay and some longer range translations. The light on the back of the MMU is a locator light in case we got to flying around in the darkness so Vance could keep an eye on where we were. Basically, we were very pleased with the way the MMU handled. It was very much like the simulations at the Martin Company in Denver, except that we did find that when translating with the attitude hull system activated, since we had built it to conserve propellant by turning some of the thrusters off, if you started to pick up a rotational rate, this hadn't been modeled in detail in the simulator. You got an averaged response, and of course here you could feel every little thruster coming on and off. But other than that, the flying characteristics were virtually identical to the simulator. And of course, here we had complete freedom to turn somersaults and maneuver about all three rotational axes. And actually, the orbital mechanics were much more realistic. And of course, the quality of the visuals, that is, the scene, was a lot higher here than in any simulator. Here I am, I guess, backing out to 150 feet, coming back in, and then out to 300 and coming back in. This is approximately the same sort of translation that the folks on the next mission, the Solar Maximum Repair Mission, will be faced with in moving from the orbiter over to the Solar Maximum spacecraft.
It was interesting seeing Bob and Bruce go out to 300 yards. We had some qualms about it before the flight. We were concerned to have a naturally human being out that far untethered, but we had backup procedures to go get them if anything went wrong with their equipment. So by the time flight came along, we were quite happy with the idea, and it turned out to be not bad.
Back inside the cabin after the first EVA, one of the tasks was to recharge and replenish the pressure suits, or EMUs. This shot here shows installing a fresh lithium hydroxide cartridge, which absorbs the exhaled carbon dioxide in your breath, thereby
Bruce McCandless, mission specialist. The mission emblem on the cake on the breakfast table, which is Discovery with the Hubble Space Telescope on a field of planets, stars. This is shuttle launch control at T-minus. Here is Navy Captain Bruce McCandless. McCandless and Kathy Sullivan will be doing the contingency EVA on this flight should one be necessary. Crew now headed for the elevator that will take them down to the first floor where they'll board the Astrovan for the 20-minute ride out to Pad B. The commander and the pilot, Commander Shriver and pilot Charlie Bolden, Bruce McCandless, and members of the support team that will be going out. There is the crew headed down the elevator. And momentarily, we'll see them boarding the Astrovan. And numerous KSC employees usually wait by the walkway to greet them as they head out. Main engine start. We are go for main engine start. T-minus 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery with the Hubble Space Telescope, our window on the universe.
Mission Control, Houston.
Roll program.
Roger, roll, Discovery.
The roll maneuver puts the vehicle in the proper launch plane. Guidance officer confirms a good roll maneuver. Engines now throttling back. The throttle down maneuver assists in reducing the aerodynamic loads on Discovery as it passes through the area of maximum dynamic pressure. Velocity now 1,200 feet per second. Discovery downrange 3 nautical miles.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
All three engines now throttled back up.
Go at throttle up.
Engines at 104%. The go at throttle up call signifies that all systems are performing well. All three auxiliary power units look good. Discovery's velocity now 2,300 feet per second and is downrange 8 nautical miles.
Photographic equipment on the flight deck to document the deploy activities.
Discovery, Houston.
Go ahead, Spike.
You got a go to release the Perlers and a go to transfer Hubble to internal power on time.
Three panels out.
Thanks, Lauren.
When fully deployed, both of the arrays together produce about 6,000 volts, about half of which is required to operate telescope systems, and during the daylight side of the pass, the other half is used to recharge the 6 nickel hydrogen batteries. Shift supervisor Pete Patero just checking with his control team, receiving a report that from the ground, as confirmed by the crew from orbit, the deploy activity so far is going very smoothly. We see no indications of any problems at this time.
Discovery, you can go auto burn. We're setting up for the other array.
Okay, we'll go auto burn.
That's firm.
Copy that, Story. Thank you. And status for you, Houston. Charlie's downstairs in the process of getting Bruce and Kathy buttoned up in the suits.
AVA copies, and we're watching the fans come on. Discovery, we'd like free drift for minus SDM deploy.
Okay, we copy free drift.
That's firm.
Okay, you're in free drift now.
Thank you.
Sir, we see motion.
So do we, Lauren.
As the blankets begin deploying, the orbital verification team is watching very closely the tension being placed on those wings so far. Looking good.
Discovery, go for Hubble release.
Okay, we have a go for release, and we're going to be a minute late.
Okay, Charlie.
Houston Discovery.
Go ahead, Charlie.
Okay, Story, we've been taking marks. Residuals and ratios look good, and we'd like to go ahead and go to filter state.
We concur, Charlie.
Sorry, I was taking pictures. I may have missed your call. You want to go ahead and do RMS power down so we can get the guys out of the airlock set up for them?
But that's at your convenience, Steve. But once we do have the RMS stowed, then we'll back out of EVA.
Okay. I'll tell you what. We'll spend just a few more minutes then getting some pictures here.
Yes, sir. Do just that.
To our training team who worked really so hard with us for... actually, quite a long time, a couple of years while I've been with the crew anyway, so we really appreciate all the long hours and late hours and all the hard work that they did, and it's really paid off, we believe, and we'd like to thank them for the little cards they gave us to read while we're here on orbit. They're very appropriate, and we'd just like to let them know that all's going well. We're feeling great, and to give Becky our official signal.
Okay, I'm sure they're watching. If they don't happen to be right now, I will call them.